Hello dear students, in this video we will discuss chapter 7 respiration in plants. First we will talk what is respiration. As we all know that all living cells in plant as well as in animals required energy for the various body's activities, and this energy is made available by the breakdown of glucose, and this process is known as respiration. Respiration is the process of breaking down of glucose to liberate energy. As a byproduct, it gives carbon dioxide and water. In other words, we can say respiration is the process of oxidation of food. Here food is glucose. Oxidation of food, here food is glucose, to liberate energy in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. And here the respiration shows three important characteristics. The first one is breakdown of glucose. This breakdown of glucose into pyruvate. This glucose is first breaking down into pyruvate, and the process is called glycolysis. It occurs inside the cytoplasm, and then this pyruvate again converted into carbon dioxide, water and ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate, and it occurs in mitochondria. And secondly, for every breakdown step, a particular kind of enzyme is required, and the energy liberated in these breakdowns are heat energy and chemical energy in the form of ATP, that is adenosine triphosphate. When this energy in the form of ATP is utilized by the body, then it converted into ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate. And again, when more energy is available by the further breakdown of glucose, this ADP is again converted into ATP. And this process is going on again and again throughout the life. The ATP, which is the energy currency of a cell, is produced by the process of respiration. This ATP is considered as the energy currencies, because energy in the form of ATP is needed for all the activities inside a living cell. Again, we can say this respiration is a catabolic pressure of releasing energy from simple sugar glucose for carrying out life processes. Here, to understand catabolic process, we should know first that all living cells performs metabolic activities, or in all living cells metabolic reactions are taking place. These metabolic reactions are combination of two different reactions. One is called anabolic and the other one is called catabolic. Anabolic reactions are biosynthetic reactions or constructive reactions. They synthesize food. Whereas catabolic reactions are breaking down process, breaking down reactions or destructive reactions. They break down food molecules into smaller and absorbable molecules to liberate energy which are required by the plants. So respiration is a catabolic process, means respiration is breaking down process. It breaks down glucose to release, to liberate energy, and a byproduct, it also gives out carbon dioxide and water. Now sometimes this respiration is compared with burning. Respiration compared with burning because both liberate energy and both gives out carbon dioxide and water as a end product, as a byproduct. Here some comparisons are given, like respiration occurs in a series of stages, whereas burning takes place in a simple single stage. This respiration carried out by the help of enzymes, whereas burning carried out by heat. Respiration is a biochemical process, but burning is a physiochemical process. Energy liberated in the form of ATP in respiration and in burning, energy liberated in the form of light and heat energy. Respiration is a cellular process, whereas burning is a non-cellular process. Respirations occurs at body temperature, where burnings occurs at higher than the body temperature, and this temperature is different from different substances, means different substance burns at different temperature, and that temperature in which that substance burn is known as ignisus point. Now here we will talk about the parts of the plants through which it respires. Every part of the plant, such as leaves, stems, roots, helps in respirations. And the tiny openings or pores, which helps in exchange of gases or diffusion of gases, are located in leaves, in stems, and on roots. So here that pores are stomata, which is present in leaves, lenticels, which is present in old woody stems, and the general surface of roots. Generally, it is found in mangroves, which grow in marshy lands. In mangrove, the roots comes out from the soil to help in diffusion of gases. Now, children, you know why tilling or plowing of soil is done. This is done to loosen the soil. This loose soil can trap oxygen, which is required for the process of respiration. This oxygen, which is trapped in soil, is utilized by the root for the process of respiration. That's why this plowing or tilling is done. The waterlogged or dry soils have no oxygen, so it reduces the process of respirations. Here, the carbon dioxide produced during respiration in the leaves serves as a raw material for the process of photosynthesis. And during the daytime, the photosynthesis of the leaves produce oxygen. Some of this oxygen is utilized for the process of respiration, and the rest is diffused out, which are inhaled by animals and living organisms, other living organisms. Now here it is advisable that at night one should not sleep under trees. Why? Because it is believed that at night plants or leaves obtain oxygen from the atmosphere and gives out carbon dioxide. That's why it is advisable that one should not sleep under trees at night. Now we'll talk about types of or kinds of respiration. There are two kinds of respiration. One is known as aerobic respiration, and the other one is known as anaerobic respiration. In aerobic respiration, the glucose is oxidized with the help of oxygen, and carbon dioxide, water, and energy in the form of ATP is liberated. It means the reaction in which oxygen is required, oxygen is needed, that reaction is known as aerobic respiration, or the respiration in which oxygen is involved is known as aerobic respiration. This aerobic respiration liberate large amount of energy compared to anaerobic respiration. This is very important to keep in your mind that for aerobic respiration oxygen is required, and it liberate large amount of energy, that is 38 ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Now we will talk about anaerobic respiration. Here in anaerobic respiration, the energy produced is very less, that is only 2 ATP energy is liberated. In this anaerobic respiration, oxygen is not required, or the respiration in which oxygen is not involved is known as anaerobic respiration. Here, glucose oxidizes or breaks down into ethanol, which is also called ethyl alcohol, and carbon dioxide, and liberate energy in the form of ATP, that is adenosine diphosphate. This anaerobic respiration is taking place in small bacteria and fungi. In human beings also, when we are playing, we require more and more oxygen. To fulfill the requirement of oxygen of our muscles, muscles start doing anaerobic respiration, due to which in human bodies or in human muscles, lactic acid produced, and when this lactic acid accumulated inside the muscles, muscles get tired, muscles get fatigue. Here in case of plant cells, in anaerobic respiration ethanol is produced, but in animal cells lactic acid is produced, and when we sit, take rest for some time, this lactic acid oxidized, again we acquired energy. So here in anaerobic respiration, glucose is broken into ethanol and carbon dioxide and liberate a little energy. This generally takes place in small bacteria and fungi. Now here is some comparison between aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Here this aerobic respiration, as by definition we know, is completed in the process of presence of oxygen, whereas anaerobic respiration proceed or completed without oxygen. Here in aerobic respiration there is a complete breakdown of glucose, whereas in anaerobic respiration there is incomplete breakdown of glucose. The byproduct of this aerobic respiration is carbon dioxide and water, and the byproduct of this anaerobic respiration is ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide. Here this aerobic respiration liberate large amount of or large quantity of energy, that is 38 ATP, whereas anaerobic respiration liberate small quantity of energy, that is only 2 ATP. And this is very important that aerobic respiration is taking place throughout the lifetime, whereas anaerobic respiration is taking place for short duration, for a short period of time in the case of emergency. Now here respiration is compared with photosynthesis. Here respiration's product is required for the process of photosynthesis, and the product of photosynthesis is required for the respiration. That's why they are called complementary to each other, and this is the reason that we cannot conduct the experiment on plant respiration during daytime. Here respirations and photosynthesis are somehow here compared. Now here photosynthesis occurs in the presence of chlorophyll, whereas respirations occurs in all living cells, whether chlorophyll is present or not. The photosynthesis occurs only in the presence of light during daytime, whereas respirations occur at any time. Here in photosynthesis, carbon dioxide and water is used, whereas in respiration, oxygen and glucose is used. During respiration, oxygen is liberated, and during this respiration, carbon dioxide is released as a byproduct. Here in photosynthesis, light energy is converted into chemical energy, and in respiration, chemical energy is converted into heat energy and other useful forms of energy which is used by the body for various activities. And the result of the photosynthesis, there is a gain in weight, whereas due to the respiration, there is a loss in weight. Now we'll talk about respiration in plant. Respiration in plants compared with the respiration in animals. As I told previously that in plant cell, the byproduct of this, the end product of this anaerobic respiration is ethanol or ethyl alcohol, whereas in animal cell it is lactic acid. This lactic acid is responsible for the fatigueness of tiredness of muscles. In a plant, no gaseous transport is taking place, only respiratory gas diffuse in and out by the cell to cell diffusion. But in animal cell, gases are transferred from one place to another with the help of blood. Now in a plant cell, very less amount of heat energy is produced during this respiration, but in animal cells, a large amount of heat is produced during this respiration. Now dear children, hopefully you have understood this chapter well. If you have any queries or question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you very much.